of 6 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
I got you, punk.
Mike 34, Mike
check,
34.
Check. Here we go.
Snake eyes.
Snake eyes. Check, check. Regular, regular, run.
The intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
Roger, Roger! 34's the mic! 34's the mic! Stay with your
check,
man.
Check! Set!
We got swarm to the ball, swarm to the ball.
There we go, Lewis,
Pete! That's the one you hit! Wilson makes the tackle at the 48-yard line. That'll make it fourth and two. Of 6 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Four down.
Hey, well, Mike 34.
Let's go! Whitey! Hot!
The pass falls incomplete. Carter, the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Check fast. Hey, check Mike 34!
Set! Whitey!
Green
Niner!
Wilson on the tackle, the 36-yard line. That'll make it third and one.
Got double tight! Double tight!
Three down, three down!
Here we go!
Thank you.
Lewis with the run. Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
And now, a word from Michigan State quarterback Tom Gillian. Well, it was pretty much an overall great effort by our guys. Pretty much we wanted to give our home crowd a very good show, which was kind of obvious by the final score. Pretty much is always kind of fun to have one of those games pretty much where you absolutely dominate on both sides of the ball. Not necessarily for the other side, but pretty much we kind of breathed a little bit after last week at Oregon. Pretty much we were kind of a little bit stressed out, but pretty much coaches pretty much this week told us to relax a bit. Pretty much not have to worry about it, even though we pretty much are in the top 5 in the country. So pretty much all facets of the game did an absolutely great job. Offensive line, running backs, myself, defense, special teams, we did absolutely wonderful. Absolutely great, overall great game. I did have that one interception, but pretty much I made up for it pretty much with those two passing touchdowns and then one rushing. But overall, good game to start off the home stretch. So I think that's all I really need to say. Thanks, guys. Alright, so let's go ahead and advance this week into week 5. We'll take a look at top stories, take a look at top 25, conference standings, and see who's on the Heisman watch. Wouldn't be too surprised if I'm not on there, on that list. But I'm recording this on Sunday night, so pretty much by the time this gets uploaded, hopefully my voice is a little bit better. I'm dealing with a dumb cold. Let's see, so pretty much Auburn sends number 3 Texas A&M home with a shocking 34-23 defeat. Oof. Granted, it was at home, but still, you gotta win your games, man. And the Gators beat Tennessee by a fairly big margin, by 24. Let's see, Columbus, Ohio State beats Virginia Tech 38-17. And number 9 loses to freaking Eastern Carolina. Wow. The freaking Pirates, of all people, would beat the freaking Tar Heels. Granted, Tar Heels in football is not that great compared to basketball. Seeing the Cornhuskers go on the road against Northwestern. That'll be a very good matchup there. Number 5 takes on number 6. That'll be another good game there. And LSU beats Mississippi State 34-17. Georgia beats Arkansas 30-27. So take a look at the polls here, see who stacks up. Not surprised there, Alabama number 1, Texas number 2. We move up a spot to number 3, Ohio State close behind, number 4, Clemson 5, Florida State 6. One of those two is going to lose by week's end. Let's see, Georgia Tech, number 7, Florida goes to number 8 after being at number 12, Oklahoma, number 9. Those two make the biggest moves up, and Virginia Tech loses, it goes to number 10. Conference standings. Let's see, Minnesota and Nebraska lose. So pretty much only Iowa, Northwestern, Michigan State, and Michigan are pretty much leading Legends division. And the leaders, Penn State, Indiana, Ohio State, which are undefeated right now, Wisconsin, Illinois, and Purdue. Purdue gets a win. Let's see, who did Purdue beat? Ooh, FCS Northwest by not a big margin of 17-10. Wow. Let's see, Heisman watch, Pat Crowder, see, Mark Blanks, Joel Meadows of Washington, Michael King of Florida, Ben Morris, huge surprise, pretty much all of them are seniors, but pretty much I think we'll call this good. Next week we'll be at home against Eastern Michigan, and then we'll start with our Big Ten schedule. But until then, my name is DarthTom, and I will see you guys next time.